WWT 6 News is learning who may have been responsible behind a scam that has angered so many. You remember the news broke late last week that someone had stolen official ticket card stock and forged tickets to a popular concert. Tonight, our Matthew Smith reports on evidence pointing to one person.
She came, she saw, she conquered. The seven-time Grammy Award-winning Taylor Swift is about as big as it gets in the entertainment world. But not everyone could see her two sold-out shows in Omaha.
I never sued a friend before.
Jen Holberman paid nearly $250 to go to Friday's show. A friend who worked at CenturyLink said she had access to tickets. When WOWT 6 News broke the story of sham tickets, fake, sold to people unaware a massive scam was underway, Jen became suspicious. She had never even gotten hers.
I'm more sad that I've known her for 20 years. I would never do that to somebody. I wouldn't think somebody would do that back to me.
Holberman has proof that the woman she bought tickets from cashed the check. She even showed me her bank's copy of the check. And the messages between the one-time friends, one where she even names the price.
Now, WOWT 6 News is not going to name the woman that Holberman believes is behind this whole sham. Police aren't naming a suspect. That's why we aren't. But Holberman, for her part, did do a bit more digging, found out that woman did, in fact, work here at the CenturyLink Center, but at this point, she no longer does. That's interesting because in this police report, it says the people who were in charge of selling Friday and Saturday night's tickets, they believe the person who got the fraudulent tickets was a former employee.
The ripple effect that she has done is horrible.
Holberman tells me she just wants her money back. As to the woman she thinks did it.
I think karma's gonna come get her. And it should. It should.
Karma apparently won't be the only thing going after that alleged ticket scammer. In fact, Holberman tells me because Monday's a holiday, she plans to be at the courthouse first thing Tuesday morning. She wants to file a lawsuit, John, because she wants to be first in line to potentially get her money back.
Well, Matt, we'll continue to work with police to learn if that woman is indeed the ticket scammer suspect that they think. And stick with us, WWT 6 News, for the latest. Thanks, Matthew Smith reporting.